Have you guys ever wanted to mint an NFT or play around in DeFi, use Aave, use MakerDAO, and use all these different dApps, and then you see the gas fees and you're like, eh, I think I'm okay? Well, there's a solution for that, and the project is called Polygon. Everything you know and love on Ethereum, but cheaper gas fees. In today's KuCoin DigiDive, we're going to be breaking into Polygon, talking to you guys about what they're looking to do, explain to you guys a couple things on their chain, and what the vision is of the community. If you guys would like to go ahead and get started trading with this coin, links in the description below. We'll give you 20% off trading fees, baby. And you'll also get a chance to get $500 in free USDT after your first few trades. All right, let's go ahead and get into Polygon. Bringing the world to Ethereum. This is their MO. The TLDR and the best way to understand Polygon is that it's Ethereum, but you now have less gas fees. This is a proof of stake blockchain instead of a proof of work. Currently, Ethereum is proof of work. So going on DeFi Llama, we can see a list of a few of the dApps that are on Polygon. I mean, the list goes on and on and on and on and on and on. And it's kind of ironic. Poly means many. So yeah, they have many projects on Polygon. And they have the classic, all the ones we know and love. Aave, you have QuickSwap. This is similar to Uniswap, but it's on Polygon, lower gas fees. You have Curve. This is really good for swapping between like pairs and stable coins and whatnot. You have Stargaze, you have SushiSwap, Uniswap, and so on. There's several different protocols built on Polygon. Just look at Polygon like Ethereum, but lower gas fees and faster transactions. So as you guys can see here in MATIC terms, it seems to be somewhat steady. It has about $1.5 billion worth of USD locked into the protocol. And we are in somewhat of a downtrend right now. So that's why the US dollar terms look lower. But if you look at it in crypto terms, it looks like it's steadying out. So time will tell. We'll see what will happen on this one. So we just went over a couple of dApps that were on DeFi Llama, but there's over 19,000 different dApps to choose from on Polygon. You can specify by DeFi, you can do NFTs, you can do dApps, games, DAO, utility. There's different projects and protocols that you can specify by. So Polygon is a layer 2 sidechain. This is looking to help scale Ethereum by handling transactions that are on Ethereum mainnet layer 1 by taking them on Polygon. And this has to do with bridging over on Polygon and doing your transactions over there. And also the layer 2 sidechains are able to operate in parallel capacity to Ethereum. So Ethereum can still run and Polygon still is able to run as well. The nodes within this Polygon sidechain are responsible for confirming the transactions and processing them. The nodes on the Polygon sidechain are responsible for confirming and processing transactions on each of the blocks. They're also responsible for maintaining consensus across the network. And what's important to understand about Polygon is that it's not taking its security from Ethereum. It's actually depending on the MATIC and the Polygon token. This is through the proof of stake network that they have. If you hold some MATIC tokens, you can actually stake these tokens and provide additional security to the Polygon network. So as you guys can see here, this is the staking dashboard. You can select any of these to delegate to. If you have some MATIC, just be aware of the commission and the checkpoint signed. The more checkpoints, the better. The higher the commission, just keep in mind they're going to be taking a percentage of the staking rewards that you guys get. In theory, the lower commission, the more that you will earn. But it comes with a caveat. Remember, these guys got to eat too. So having a little bit of commission is okay. Then you have the Polygon bridge. This is specifically getting from Ethereum to Polygon. There's also on-ramp transfers. Like if you don't have any funds in your wallet, you can use the on-ramp transfers in order to bring funds onto Polygon. So pretty easy and convenient ways to do this, especially for retail. A couple of features of Polygon and its speeds and scalabilities. The transaction speeds are up to 7,000 transactions per second. So Ethereum is about 15 in comparison. You also have the non-custodial architecture because you hold the keys to your crypto. This would be like your MetaMask, your Trust wallet, or your Coinbase wallet, or any of the wallets that you're using. You also have efficient bridging, deposits, and withdrawals through that feature that I showed you. It's literally a click of a button, and to bridge back and forth, it'll take you about 30 minutes depending on the confirmation times. And it also relies on the shared security of Ethereum. This protocol is EVM compatible, So any other projects that are on Ethereum or on Binance Smart Chain or on Phantom or other EVM chains that are actually convertible over onto Polygon and can be bridged over. So just think everything you know and love on these different chains, but lower gas fees. So fractional costs per transactions based on Polygon's proof of stake architecture. And on top of this, there's also EIP 1559 like mechanics with Polygon, so there are token burns. So this is a general overview of how this would work. You would have the Ethereum mainnet, and this is the root chain. This is where most of the transactions are going. You also have these checkpoint nodes. The checkpoint nodes are going to be going back from Polygon and onto the root chain of Ethereum. So MATIC's sidechain is processing all these different transactions and making all these different computations and giving a summary on each of the checkpoints. The checkpoints are going onto the main chain. This is how they're able to do it cheaper. And it's through, I guess you can consider it like batches. Now, what's going to be super interesting with Polygon is the ZK rollup. When you thought speeds and transactions couldn't get any cheaper, this will be the upgrade that changes the way you look at Polygon. The transactions will be much faster and they will still be much cheaper. So you can have all these different thousands and thousands and thousands of transactions all put into one transaction that's placed on Ethereum. And how they do this is with zero knowledge technology. How this would work is, let's say for example, I want to prove to you I have a lot of money without actually showing you my bank account. What I could do is I can purchase a car or purchase something that's very, very expensive. And you'd be like, oh, he can buy that. He's got money to do so. So I basically showed you I have a lot of money without actually showing you my bank account. That's a way you can think of zero knowledge technology. Knowing a fact about something without actually knowing it. Just proof you have that knowledge. So what's also really cool about the Polygon technology is these supernets. The supernets are a little bit different on Polygon than the regular dApps that are running on an EVM. With supernets, other chains, other games, and other communities, they are able to launch their own chain and using the Polygon proof of stake network to be able to run their own chain. So how this would work is validators verify all their own transactions on the supernet. Validators would need to stake their MATIC tokens on mainnet before validating the network, and any validator misbehavior will have repercussions, as in slashing. They will lose a portion of their stake. So this is really important with a supernet, because if I have my own chain, it's actually independent from these other chains. So let's say, for example, Aave and Compound have their own chain, or another NFT protocol. If that NFT does a NFT drop and it causes a bunch of congestion on my chain, normally if we're on the same thing, Aave and Compound would also be congested. But if I have my own sovereign independent chain, my chain will still do its thing, Compound will still do its thing, and the NFT drop or that drop happen on that chain, it's going to be congested as pants and it stays isolated with them. So it doesn't affect everyone else. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the tokenomics of Polygon. MATIC is used for both staking and for transaction fees. It can also be used as an asset in DeFi and with these NFTs. So this is the breakdown of the token distribution. As you can see here, 19% went to the Binance Launchpad sale, 16% to the team, 4% to advisors, and you can see the rest here. This is also a breakdown of the airdrops, founders, and investors. This is just specifically broken down as a portion. Here's an overview of the supply schedule. The maximum supply is going to be 10 billion tokens. As you can see here, towards the end of 2022, we will start seeing the token unlocks slow down and the emissions of the Polygon token go way down. So overall, what are my closing thoughts? I really like how they're looking to scale and solve some of the issues with Ethereum. Gas fees definitely price out a lot of users. And the TLDR on Polygon is that it's looking to solve these problems with its layer 2 solutions. I really like the idea of the zero knowledge technology coming out to further scale it, as well as the transformation of Ethereum into a multi-chain ecosystem by scaling Ethereum's issues. So you can think of Polygon, everything you know and love on these other chains, but much cheaper. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let's go and hit you guys with a wisdom one-liner. Proverbs chapter 14, verses 35. A king delights in a wise servant, but a shameful servant arouses his Fury. Be wise, be good, be nice. If you guys enjoyed this KuCoin DigiDive, make sure you smash up the like, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell notification. That way you guys are notified every time we make a new one. Tell me what you guys think of Polygon. Do you like it? Does it stink? What do you think of it? Check out some of our previous videos here, 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 and like there. We'll see you in the next one.